Good morning, welcome back to the channel Awesome Learning. And today in the chapter photosynthesis we are going to discuss the topic sight and the pigments, that is what is the site or where is the site where the photosynthesis takes place and what are the pigments that are involved in photosynthesis. So let's begin with that. We all know that photosynthesis takes place in chloroplast. So the site that we were talking about is the chloroplast. Just excuse me. Photosynthesis takes place in green leaves and other green parts of the plant. Chloroplast present in the walls of mesophyll cells of the leaf. Now you have to go through the structure of the leaf, where you will see that the anatomy of leaf is divided into many layers of cells, that is the upper epidermis and the lower epidermis, and in between there are many cells like palisades, spongy parenchyma, mesophyll cells. So these are the cells where chloroplasts are present. So it helps to get optimum quantity of incident light. Now you know the light which falls on the object is the incident light. So the chloroplasts have chlorophyll or the pigment, and they try to grab optimum, that is maximum quantity of energy from the incident light that is falling on it. ठीक है, उनकी कोशिश होती है कि जितनी भी लाइट उनके ऊपर गिर रही है, इंसिडेंट लाइट जितनी भी आ रही है उनके ऊपर, उससे मैक्सिमम क्वांटिटी एब्जॉर्ब कर ले वो. सो क्लोरोप्लास्ट कंटेन्स अ मेम्ब्रेनस सिस्टम, दैट इज इट इज अ मेम्ब्रेन ब्राउन स्ट्रक्चर. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ ग्राना, एज यू सी इन द डायग्राम हियर, दिस इज ग्राना. स्ट्रोमा लैमेले, द connections that connect grana are stroma lamellae, and the fluid stroma, that is the light greenish part, is the fluid stroma. Each granum is a group of membrane bound sacs. Now one, this whole granum, this is whole granum, and you can see this is again a granum, and each granum has stacks, you see, various stacks or sacs called thylakoids. These are the thylakoids. Okay, they contain the leaf pigment, and the membrane of these thylakoids, the membrane of the thylakoids have the pigment, that is the chlorophyll. Now the membrane system traps light energy and synthesize ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate, and NADPH. Okay, so when the membrane system traps light energy to synthesize these products, this is called light reaction, because here light is being trapped, it is being used. You can see light reactions, ATP is formed here, NADP is formed here. Now this ATP and NADP, which is formed in the light reaction, are used by the dark reaction. Okay, so in stroma, enzymatic reactions incorporate CO2 into the plant for synthesizing sugar. Now CO2 is being used to synthesize sugar. If you remember the basic or the empirical formula, if you remember this empirical formula, so where is this CO2 used? Because yesterday we studied that hydrogen is being used by water, and the byproduct oxygen is given by this oxygen that was in the water. That means this CO2 is used to make the carbohydrate, right? The CO2 was totally used to make a carbohydrate. So that is why here we can say this, that in stroma the enzymatic reactions take place and the CO2 is used in synthesizing sugar, and with this sugar will convert into starch. So this step in which CO2 is combined to form a sugar and then the sugar will be formed starch, this whole step is taking place in the dark reaction. So photosynthesis is divided into two parts. First part is the light reaction and second part is the dark reaction. So what happens in the light reaction? In the light reaction, oxygen, the byproduct, is taken out and two products, that is ATP and NADPH, are formed. These are the steps of light reaction. Now, whatever the products are formed here by the light reaction, they are used by the dark reaction along with the CO2 to form the starch or the sugar, and that is why we call it as dark reaction. Now we call it as dark reaction, but that doesn't mean that this reaction takes place in the night or during the dark hours. It does not mean that it takes place in the darkness, or they are not light dependent. Of course they are light dependent, because dark reaction will depend on ATP and NADPH, and these two come from light reaction, so they do depend on light. But yes, we call it as dark reaction because they indirectly depend on sunlight, not directly. So I hope this is clear about the chloroplast. Now, pigments that are involved in photosynthesis. Now, children, you see here, pigments are the substances that have the ability to absorb the light. Now, in yesterday's class, as I told you, that chlorophyll A and B, when you were doing the experiments and you were asking me doubts, so I told you that chlorophyll A and B try to absorb maximum light energy in the band of blue and red light, okay, because of a particular wavelength. So yes, this is true. They have the ability to absorb light at specific wavelengths. So chromatography shows the following leaf pigment in chromatogram. You can see this is a chromatography, and various leaf pigments are shown. Chlorophyll A, B, then chlorophyll A, then xanthophyll, and this is carotene. Okay, so this shows that chlorophyll A is absorbed bright or blue green, B absorbs yellow, xanthophyll yellow, and carotenoid yellow to yellow orange. You can see on a chromatogram. So chlorophyll B, xanthophylls, and carotenoids are accessory pigments. They are accessory pigments. The main pigment is chlorophyll A. Okay. Functions of accessory pigments are, they absorb light at different wavelengths. Dekho, carotenoids, chlorophyll B is at different wavelengths, xanthophyll, carotenoids on different wavelengths. Theek hai? And what they do is, they absorb light at different wavelengths, then they transfer this energy to chlorophyll A. Because the major pigment is chlorophyll A. So what happens, they are accessory pigments, na? So they will absorb the light energy from various wavelengths and they will transfer that energy to chlorophyll A. And they will also protect chlorophyll A from photooxidation, because if chlorophyll A oxidizes, then it will not be in a role to play. जो भी role उसने play करना है वो नहीं कर पाएगा, because अगर वो oxidize हो गया, oxidize means अगर उसमें या तो oxygen add हो गया या hydrogen delete हो गया, अगर ऐसा कोई reaction हो गया chlorophyll A में, तो जो वो काम कर सकता है वो नहीं कर पाएगा. इसलिए accessory pigments protect chlorophyll A. So they can ask you, give two functions of accessory pigments. So these are the two points that you should write. Then the absorption spectrum and action spectrum coincide closely. Children, there is a minute difference. The spectrum, absorption spectrum, and the action spectrum, where actually the action will take place. So they are very close, showing that photosynthesis is maximum at blue and red regions of the spectrum. So the graph also shows that chlorophyll A is the chief pigment associated with the photosynthesis. Now you see here graph showing absorption spectrum of chlorophyll A, B, and carotenoids. So you can see chlorophyll A, it goes to the, see, wavelength blue may, and then it is also good at red. So blue and red are chlorophyll A, and with chlorophyll B, it is highest in this particular wavelength, that is in between blue and the other color. And carotenoids ka orange wala hai, they have depicted it with orange line. graph showing action spectrum of photosynthesis. Thus, you see rate of photosynthesis increasing by oxygen release. So rate of photosynthesis is see highest in chlorophyll, that is blue region. This is blue, and here also in green also it is highest, right? Then here graph showing action spectrum imposed on absorption spectrum of chlorophyll A. This is again, they are showing these two graphs, they have merged. Okay, now they are only showing about chlorophyll A. So, ye dono graphs ko unhone ek graph mein bana diya hai. Aap ye dekh sakte ho, they are here, they are showing the absorption of chlorophyll A by blue line, and they are also showing the maximum absorption that will be done by the and the rate of the photosynthesis. They are showing the rate of photosynthesis here. Yani absorption bhi high hai blue region mein and rate of photosynthesis bhi high hai. Aise hi red region mein absorption bhi high hai and rate of photosynthesis bhi high hai. So that means kaun sa color jo hai that is good, which wavelength? Of course blue and red are good because absorption bhi high hai and rate of photosynthesis dono regions mein good hai. Okay, so this is all about pigments involved in photosynthesis and the site of photosynthesis.